David, I've built a model of Captain Torres and three strikes. Based on your hypothesis and mission parameters
from the past, I ran a precision combat simulation. But it failed.
Bummer. Why didn't it work?
Reasons in sensuous order are... 1. Your hypothesis is trash. 2. The parameters you gave me are trash.
Did I do something to tick you off?
3. Captain Torres is a singularity.
So the values diverge. But what about this one? 4. Three strikes is a singularity.
That's outside the confidence interval. The possibility that it's 1, 2, or 3 is 99%.
What?
Significance is high.
Try this. This is three strikes data before he's assigned to the LRSSG.
The Erusean military is gathering its remaining naval forces at Anchorhead Bay. Apparently, they're even bringing in ships from the Mothball fleet. This is probably to reinforce their naval power in preparation for the showdown in Farbanti. We've received intel that the Alicorn will also be joining them.
From which source, Brigadier General? There's a possibility the Alicorn's former crew have been tasked with sabotage.
Your job is to analyze the enemy's weaponry. From now on, speak only when authorized. I don't hear a response.
May I be authorized to speak first, sir?
When we're done, I'll be talking to your superiors. Here's your mission. LRSSG is to raid Anchorhead. Carry out airstrikes on Anchor Bay to the north and Dockyuck Bay to the south, inflicting all possible damage. If we can strip the port of its naval functions, we can also prevent the submarine from joining forces.
The area around Anchorhead is Erusean territory. To delay hostile detection, you will sortie in small numbers and make your way in at super low altitudes.
Small sortie? Who's going?
Count, Lanza, Hujan, and Trigger. 4 aircraft from Strider Squadron will be deployed.
Well, all right, I got this.
To cover our lack of numbers, we're giving you plenty of opportunities to resupply. Look here, we've set up multiple return lines. Make full use of them to resupply and change armaments. Also note that the enemy will not be able to mount a defense immediately after detecting it. Use this window to destroy high-threat targets. That should make things much easier for you.
It should also raise the survival rate.
Survival rate, huh?
The element of surprise and resupplying are the key. Beyond that, I just need a couple of pilots who will stick to my orders. We don't need an ace to succeed. Got anything to say? Good.
Brigadier General.
That is all.
David, go on.
Let me share the career of Mateus Torres, captain of the submarine Alicorn. Does anyone know how his people hailed him?
A bit unfair to provide us with next to no hints, don't you think?
Fair enough. The hero of Cumberth Harbor is the answer. He was a captain of the battleship Tanagere at the time of the Continental War. It led Aegir Fleet, the invincible armada. But when the fleet was destroyed at Cumberth Harbor, so was his ship.
Yet, he's the hero?
He was able to bring most of his crew home with accurate damage control and precise evacuation orders. Then, there's the accident with the Alicorn. Many believe that if they stay with him, they'll live. Transfer from surface to underwater is unusual. However, considering his skill and reputation, along with the fact that the Alicorn is no ordinary submarine, it all makes sense.
It'll be a difficult mission to carry out with 4 aircraft. Still, I'd like to add one more to the mission conditions.
What, you want to make it even harder?
I want 100% survival rate for the sortie. Any other number and the mission will be considered a failure.
Thank you. squadron, proceed to runway. Sortie ASAP.
Touch the water.
Altitude restriction lifted. Begin up.
The food at this party served buffet style. Pick whatever dish you like before the host mounts a resistance.
Luco, I'll eat their hearts out.
Sorry, Trigger. The choosy targets are all mine.
Targets. Forget about your manners.
Never met any of them all again.
Had to stay behind last time. This is gonna be a walk in the park. It's a good warm-up to get back in the game.
The AA defenses have been destroyed before with activated. This will make things easier later.
Caution.
Lieutenant General Shepard. Is this sure we'll get a positive result this time?
Yes, Lieutenant General Shepard. Operation Dominoes is going as planned.
Strider 1, this is Control Tower. The runway is clear.
Chatter in that area has quieted down. Try a different location, Trigger. It looks like there are delicacies on other tables as well.
Lanza has the southern port to himself. Don't think he can go it alone.
Trigger, let's go! All right. We've wiped out most of their forces in the urban area.
I still see some ships moving. Trigger, let's go for those.
There's no need to go through the whole menu. Focus on the juicy targets.
Roger that. Here we go, Trigger.
Thank you.
ships approaching from the southeast. It's a large fleet with Aegis vessel Metis and battleship Dysnomian numbering among them. Let's do this.
Control tower, make your land.
Bank left. Strider 1, this is Control Tower. The runway is clear. Detecting enemy air reinforcements on radar. One minute remaining. Projectile detected. 10 seconds to contact. Hit.
Good. Now we have less goons to deal with. Do it, Scream.
Yeah! That's those damn bats.
Engage to let Strider 3 escape. We're calling off the patrol.
Both of you, watch out for the missiles. The missile alert didn't go off in time. Hit me as soon as I heard it.
It may be that the enemy's missiles have stolen all your lives. Their missiles may hit you immediately after the missile alert goes off.
That's the trick. Calling out to unidentified aircraft. Cease combat immediately and withdraw.
What the? Brigadier General Clements is radioing enemy aircraft on Osean channels.
Too late. Trigger's already started. I repeat, withdraw.
Don't want anyone thinking we screwed up.
Nicole.
Three strikes is calm down.
Nicole.
They're responding.
Goddamn
idiot.
Nicole.
Down.
Let's finish this once and for all, Trigger.
Kill me!
exploded. It's gone. Aircraft, eject. Eject now.
No!
Bat's blip has disappeared from our radar. At that altitude, it likely has crashed.
Serves them right. Yes. The problem has been eliminated.
Hey, chill.
Osean, stand down! Sit!
Shit, my cola.
The fleet at Anchorhead was eliminated, and we prevented the submarine from joining forces. The unidentified aircraft were shot down, too. The mission was a complete success.
Complete success, my ass!
Brigadier General, it sure seemed to me like the Bats knew you pretty damn well.
You seem to be confused. Report in for a medical check. We'll decide if you're still fit for service based on the examinations.
Cut it!
That's enough! Get the MP!
He's right. Get the MP.
Vice Chairman Edwards of the Joint Chiefs of Staff?
The Alicorn slipped into Anchorhead Bay after the mission was completed, using the confusion for cover. It resupplied quickly and escaped unharmed. Their goal was not to join forces. It was to resupply using the window we created by chasing away the Erusean forces. We did their bidding, albeit unknowingly. But the problem runs deeper than our lack of tactical acumen. Analyst North, explain for us.
Of the crew caught in the submarine accident, 330 men made it back alive. Of them, 300 are still on the sub today. Our intel has led us to believe that some or all of the 30 men who left the sub are now working as agents for the Alicorn. Sabotage, espionage, cyber propaganda, dissemination of false intel. Brigadier General, do you recognize the name Edgar Saxon, or Zool, as he used to go by? He is a former member of the Alicorn's crew, and your source of intel.
You are a fool, Brigadier General Clemens. Not only that, the radio communications during the mission suggest you are a traitor.
Sir, if you check with Lieutenant General Shepard, you'll understand that this is all just a misunderstanding.
The Lieutenant General claims you were responsible for handling all aspects of the mission. Now, let me say that again. Get the MP.
No need for that. Piece of shit.
acquired important intel from the mission. For example, the shells from long-range anti-air fire came in on depressed trajectories. Look, the estimated energy output of the railgun is 500 megajoules at least. Fired at minimum energy trajectory, range is over 3,000. They hit a powerful rail cannon aside from their main guns.
It's almost like Stonehenge.
A mobile Stonehenge.
And also, this. The Alicorn was in harbor at Anchorhead for approximately 10 minutes. They couldn't have loaded SLBMs. They loaded something smaller.
Smaller?
What is smaller and yet a powerful weapon?
Tactical nukes.
Close. The answer is tactical nuclear shells.
Nuclear shells?
No way.
Hey, he got that question right.
Nah, I missed the shell part. Quiet!
They'll likely attack our bases on the East Coast.
Their target's Ored, the Osean capital.
They want a nuclear war?
Here's a question. What's a situation where nuclear deterrence doesn't work?
Quiz guy, I've had enough of this.
Oh, only if terrorists have the nukes.
Correct.
Damn, Scald.
Hey, I'm good at trivia games.
But we're after an Erusean submarine, not terrorists.
No, he's right. HQ tells me Erusea's justification is that the Alicorn mutinied. As such, the Erusean military cannot be held responsible for the submarine's actions.
Damn.
So they intend on dropping a nuke on the Osean capital of Ored.
Here's a question for you, analyst. Just exactly who are we fighting?
Correct term is terrorist, or irregular military, but I have a different name for them. An enemy to be stopped at all costs.
Correct.